Hello and welcome to this video tutorial on basics of graphs in physics. In this video, you will learn about why we need graphs, what are graphs, and how to plot graphs. By the end of this video tutorial, students would be able to define graphs and plot graphs using data on dependent and independent variables. Let us now start with why we need graphs in physics. We need graphs in physics because a graph is a very powerful method for presenting information. We can use both tables and graphs to represent the same information, but graphs are a lot easier to read and interpret information than tables. So, having established the need for graphs, let us now define what is a graph. A graph is a line, straight or curved, that shows relationship between two quantities out of which one varies as a result of change in another. To make it clear, let us consider we have two variables, x and y, where y is equals to 2x. Now, the variable that is made to alter or change is called independent variable. And another variable which varies as a result of change in independent variable is called dependent variable. Now here, this y is dependent variable and this x is independent variable, and the values of y changes with change in values of x. Now, this relationship between independent variable and dependent variable can be shown by means of a graph. We already know that a graph is plotted to display the relation between two quantities. To understand how a graph can be plotted, consider a car is moving along a straight line. Now, the distance moved by the car in every 6 minutes is given in this table. Let us now use the example of this table and start looking at steps involved in plotting a graph. Before starting, it is important to note that here time t is the independent quantity and distance traveled x depends on time. Now, our step 1 in plotting the graph is choosing the axis. In this step, first mark the axis by drawing two perpendicular lines crossing each other at a point. Now mark x-axis and y-axis. We will take time along x-axis because generally independent variables are taken along x-axis. We will take distance, which is independent variable, along y-axis. So the line OX represent time and line OY represent distance. These lines OX and OY are named after the quantities they represent. Now, in our second step, we would choose the scale. We have to choose the scale because size of the paper on which graph is drawn is limited. Values are marked at equal distances on available length of the axis. You have to do it in such a way that all the values of the quantities represented on the axis can be accommodated in the available length. In third step, we would be plotting the points. Now, each set of values of the two quantities are represented by a point on the graph. Now, for example, the set 6 minutes and 10 kilometers is represented by a point A on the graph. To get this point, we mark 6 minutes on the axis and draw perpendicular to that point on x-axis. Similarly, locate 10 km on y-axis and draw a perpendicular to the y-axis at this point. Now, the point of intersection of these perpendicular is point A. In this way, we will mark all the information given in this table on the graph. Our fourth step would be joining the points. Once all these points corresponding to available information in the table are plotted, they are joined by a smooth curve to get a graph. Here in this case, we get a straight line that represents a uniform motion. I think now you have an idea about basics of graphs and how to plot them. So if you have knowledge of how distance varies with time for any object, you should be able to plot a distance-time graph. Similarly, you can also plot a speed-time graph using this procedure. Thanks for watching.